fundamental belief, I am my brother's keeper, I am my sister's keeper, that makes this country work. It's what allows us to pursue our individual dreams and yet still come together as one American family. E pluribus unum, out of many, one. There is not a liberal America and a conservative America. There is the United States of America. There is not a black America and a white America and Latino America and Asian America. There's the United States of America.
What the hell are you talking about?
They're going to take one of their boys, black boy, and put him in the cabin so he can walk around Washington with a cigar. Fire on one end and fool on the other. And because his immediate personal problem will have been solved, he will be the one to tell our people, look how much progress we're making. I'm in Washington, D.C. I can have tea in the White House. I'm your spokesman. I'm your leader. While our people are still living in Harlem in the slums, still receiving the worst form of education and the worst facilities in which to try and educate our children. This is the device that they will use. They'll make a black cabinet member. I read that's one of the gimmicks that they got going. But will it work? Can that one whom they are going to put down there step into the fire and put it out? And when the flames begin to leap up, when people take to the streets and their explosive moves, will that one that they're going to put in the cabinet be able to go among those people? Or they'll burn him faster than they burn the ones who've been in.
Brother Cadence.
He tricked you, had you marching down to Washington. Yeah, as you marching back and forth between the feet of a dead man named Lincoln and another dead man named George Washington, singing We Shall Overcome. He made a chump out of him. He made a fool out of him. He made you think you were going somewhere and you end up going nowhere but between Lincoln and Washington. So today our people are disillusioned. They become disenchanted. They become dissatisfied. And in their frustration, they want action. You see this young black man, this new generation. That old Uncle Tom action is outdated.
It seems a nigga can't get a job, but I can get arrested. Thought shit was changing with this black president shit. My bitch got me fucked up, going to get tested. Cause while I was locked up, she was living wrecked. Just another ordeal, a real nigga gotta deal with. If you on the bottom right now, you gotta feel this. I know that you're frustrated and you wanna kill shit. Stockpile your weapons, cause that day just might come real quick.
That old Uncle Tom action is outdated. The young generation don't want to hear anything about the odds are against us. What do we care about odds?
Minutes later, protesters then took over the intersection at 14th and Broadway in a standoff with police. The crowd continued to express their outrage over the shooting death of Oscar Grant.
They say the cop wrote a letter apologizing to Oscar. Guess they say I'm wrong, cause I still say police in the ghetto, they is killing niggas daily. But when we get to busting back, they say that we crazy. Prisons overcrowded and schools is too. Cause they undereducate you and got a place for you. Yeah, niggas go to prison in new wage slavery. Now you knowin' why they undereducate your baby.
He made the mistake of teaching me that Patrick Henry was a patriot. And George Washington wasn't nothing non-violent about old Pat or George Washington. Liberty or death was what brought about the freedom of whites in this country from the English.
They say get a job, you can think and grow rich. But what are you to do when the dollar ain't worth shit? And the jobs ain't hiring, unemployment is gone. They gon' repo your car and foreclose your home. Me, I suggest you get yourself a shotgun. So when they come to evict, you can make them run. Banks got bailed out, but we still suffering. So I got a gun, cause I done had enough of them.
Minister Malcolm, you have suggested that there are all kinds of movements in Harlem growing that you and I don't know about.
Oh, yes.
frustration itself has been sufficient, all that was necessary to make Negroes realize the importance of banding together.
They say love Jesus and listen to your pastor, but Jesus told the truth and the pastor's a lying bastard. All he talk about is economic elevation, and all Jesus talked about was soul salvation. Jesus sat with the sick and he walked with the poor, and if he gave blood for our sins, why we giving more? I got some gangster disciples in church with me tonight, with $5 worth of gas and a matchbook of life.
I'm here to tell you, in case you don't know, is we got a new generation of black people in this country who don't care anything but forever about us. They don't want to hear you old Uncle Tom handkerchief heads talking about the eyes. No. This is a new generation.